All right, fellas. Well, we're on pass two of the main threads. And now we're going to start the outside. So we're going to go two passes to the outside. Of course, always in wrapping, when you do a deco wrap, you want to, well, yeah, deco wrap or anything, you always want to stay as close as possible to your thread that you've already laid down. That way you don't have to pack as much. The less you have to abuse the threads, the better. You have to be careful sometimes when you go too much over the thread that has already been laid down, because you can cross over. Then that, if you don't see it until later, well, it's not too much of a hassle, but then you have to go back, and after you have, you know, let's say 10 threads on top of it, it's a little harder to move. All right, so that was one pass. Now we are going to start on the second pass. Since this is a plus one pattern, every pass that you do requires that many number of passes of threads. So we're on the second pass, we need two passes to the outside. On the next pass, or on the next sequence, we will go three times. Just making sure that I didn't cross over. And now we have just finished pass two on the outside. Let's go ahead and do a little bit of packing. I'm gonna throw on my handy dandy glasses here, my optivisors, so I can see. The way I pack, everybody packs differently. The way I pack is I go all the way, for the most part, I go all the way down one side first. So this side right here, I'm gonna go all the way down just this side, like this. And then I may go down this way right here, down this way, and then the other sides until I'm satisfied with the packing. I don't push with a point like this. I usually set it on the blank like this and push. Let it push like this. Not like that with the point. When you start doing that, you start abusing threads. You can bust a thread, which I did on the last wrap of this. I ended up on the main threads right here, probably on this over here. I busted, or just about busted, a thread right in here. And so I cut the last pass off and redid it. Start on this side, because it works better this way, like this. And try not to put as much pressure as I just did. I don't know if you guys saw that, you might have seen that. It's, you don't really need that much pressure. Sometimes I get a little carried away, and you will too, so just be mindful of the amount of pressure that you're putting on these threads. Last thing you want to do is cut a thread, your bottom thread down here, right down here, one of your first threads you laid down, and then you have to cut off the whole wrap because, I would cut off the whole wrap because I done busted a thread, but to each their own. Everybody packs differently. The way I pack may not be suitable for you. What I would say to that is to figure out what works best for you and go from there. I only move a little bit of thread at a time. I don't want to move a whole lot. I don't want to move it a great distance because then you have a tendency to, or you can potentially bust the thread. Sorry, a little bit of housekeeping. We do have a grown dog and a puppy. So, the grown dog tends to fuss about the UPS trucks and FedEx trucks. He doesn't like those, so I apologize in advance if Riley's barking on any of these videos. Just Bear with me on that, please. For me, this part right here is one of the most hardest because I'm pushing away versus to me. So when I pack this way to me, it's actually favorable. When I'm pushing away, I tend to slip quite a bit, so I have to be mindful of that so that I don't abuse threads. Because then once you abuse threads, you start getting burrs and little hairs and stuff from where you've kind of pulled the thread apart. Doesn't have to be perfect, but what you want to do is make sure that you get all of your threads, you know, packed as much as possible. It is a little early to pack, but this is an instructional video as well as I'm working on my personal rod, so you guys can see me work on my stuff, not just other people's stuff. And you can see how I would treat my stuff the same as I would treat someone else's. A customer or a client, same thing. What you're looking for when you have your space in here, you're looking for a somewhat of a perfect diamond shape. That way you don't want it crooked, because then your pattern is going to come out crooked. You want to make sure it's a perfect diamond. And then of course, as you get from here where it's square down to the end over here, it's going to elongate slightly. So, you know, it's going to get a little distorted, but as long as you still can maintain somewhat of a perfect diamond, or when you turn it a certain way, it makes a square. I'm having to move some threads here a little bit so I can make my square, my diamond. There we go. All right. It's packed up a little bit. Let me zoom in so you can see. I mean, it's not 100% packed, but it's still packed enough for you to be able to move on to your next progression. for patterns that are intricate and that need a step-by-step, normally I'd have the step-by-step in front of me going and marking off my steps that as I go. That way I know where I am in the pattern if I have to walk away. On this one, it's such a simple pattern that I don't necessarily need the step-by-step. I make a mental note when I walk away. I can look at it and see, okay, where I left off. If by chance you didn't mark off or complete your check mark before you walked away, what you can do, I'll tell you a little trick, is look at the last thread that's on top of all the other threads, and that'll tell you for the most part where you are in your pattern or in your sequence. So let's say right now I just wrapped that, okay? Let's say I had to walk away. Well, when I come back, what I can do is look right here. Let me zoom in so you can see. As you can see, this thread right here is above these threads and above these threads all the way around. I can also count these threads here and make sure that I have the same amount over here. If I don't have the same amount over here, well, then I know this is the last thread I've laid and I have to lay another thread here. If I was on the outside and I laid a thread here and I didn't lay threads on this side, well, I know I needed to continue over here. I hope that makes sense. Of course, this is a simple pattern, but for the most part, I urge you to always complete your step-by-steps with it, you know, with a check, just checking it off as you go. I laminate my step-by-steps. I would encourage you to laminate yours. That way you can use them over and over instead of having to print them out every time. But whatever works for you, whatever floats your boat, you do that. Sometimes my apologies, everybody. I didn't zoom back out. Yeah, sometimes these get a little, after you wash your hands, which I encourage you wash your hands every time you wrap. That way you don't have any oils or contamination on your threads. But these tend to get slight slippery and they sometimes fall out of your hand. All right, so now we have the third pass on the main threads on the inside. Now we're going to go to the outside. We're on pass number 3, so we need how many? 3 passes. That's correct. So we need 3 passes to this side, 3 passes to that side, but it's still only 3 passes. Yeah, I know it sounds crazy, but that's the way it works out. Because you're saying 3 passes to this side, 3 passes to that side, doesn't it make 6? Well, yes, it makes 6, but you're still only doing 3 passes to the outside. I'm so used to just wrapping, and I did housekeeping for the dogs, but my apologies. Of course, my wife works from home, and she's probably talking to one of her coworkers over some details as far as training, so sorry for the abrupt laughing and loud talking. All right, so we made one pass. Working on pass number two now. Sorry, I had crossed over. You guys probably didn't see that, but I crossed over here, so I had to make sure I uncrossed the threads, or jumped over, if you will. Crossed over, jumped over, whatever fits the term, whichever you use. All right, so that's pass number two. We're about to start pass number three. When you're wrapping, larger or smaller, doesn't matter. When you're wrapping, a lot of times, if you don't take a break, your hands take a beating. So, whether it be a bigger diameter or smaller diameter blank, it just doesn't matter. When you're spinning a rod around a lot, nonstop, your hands can take a beating and they start to cramp up. So, just urge you to take a break every now and then. Just meaning, like, stop and then give your hand a little rest or whatever, and then you can go back to wrapping. Alright, we're almost finished with pass three. Coming down the bottom side there. That's my wife. All right, so we finished the third pass. Now, what happens is you start to get a lot of thread on. Now, you can continue to go. If you wrap single bands, what happens is if you continue to go, it's going to get a little harder to pack the insides or pack them in because you're laying thread over thread, one thread over another, and interlocking those threads. So now, once I get three or four threads on like that, I go ahead and start to pack. That way, I don't have a whole bunch of threads to move. Because the more threads you have to move, the potential for busting a thread because you have to apply more tension is greater. Haven't put my eyes on yet. should have done that. I got a haircut, so I have to tighten these up a little bit. Yeah, there we go. It's a little better. Hey, I can actually see now. Imagine that. I don't know if you guys noticed that, but when I was packing, I would go this way and then I'd pack back this way. I'd go this way on this thread, on the outside threads, then I'd pack back to the outside with the inside threads. Just a little trick. Kind of saves you a little bit of packing. It's not the sound you want to hear. The raking of threads. Because anytime you do that, you have a potential of rusting threads. Well, it's starting to take shape.
Thank you.